Hello traders, today's video is going to be focused just on two concepts that are pretty much the same thing and how to identify them. So what we're going to look at is when do we know that a short squeeze will happen and when do we know that a long squeeze will happen. What I mean by that is when do we know that retail trading shorts are about to get destroyed and price is going to go up? When do we know that longs are about to get destroyed and price will go down? But I don't want to just focus on what I typically focus on, which is will price go up or down. I want to talk about more specifically where will price go. So that's what we're going to be talking about today. All the indicators I show you, they're paid through high block because that's the easiest way for me to show them. But you can, if you want, get them in other places as well. Every single one of these indicators you can get elsewhere, but it's going to be easier for you, of course, if you use high block. All right, so let's dive in. The previous price prediction that I had made in last Friday's video, I had predicted that price would fall. That was last Friday, of course, because I do this every Friday. That was on the 12th. So I was predicting that around here, the price would fall. Admittedly, I was a little bit wrong that price would fall. You might be like, wait, Bennett, how are you wrong? You know, you can go watch my previous video. I was wrong in the sense that I said price would fall and price actually did go up a few percent to about 25. You know, around this level. So it did go up a little bit, then it tanked. I predicted it would tank, but I was wrong in the sense that I didn't think that it would go up a few percent. So, you know, there's that. Okay, so this is, all right. By the way, kind of off topic, but it's my 25th birthday, for those who don't know, tomorrow. So happy birthday to me. And by the time you're watching this, it's probably, I'm probably already 25, so. Yay. Okay, so let's go into first the simplest indicator. So liquidation levels, I've talked about this so many times, but this is a great thing to show us with which area will price likely gravitate toward. What do we see here? Well, what I want to focus on isn't all this confusing part, you know, blah, blah, blah. I just want to focus on the right side. So basically, the farther out the line is, that means the larger the liquidation potential is at that price point. Now, as you can probably see, there's a little bit more liquidation potential higher than there is lower. That's not uncommon during a downtrend. It's actually pretty normal. But I want to talk about where is the majority of liquidation potential at, because that will tell us where to target. Around the $22,000 level and a little bit higher, what we see is a lot of potential liquidations. Hundreds of millions of dollars worth of potential liquidations can happen if price does begin to go up to the 22K level. Okay? Additionally, one more thing. If we look here, guys, what this is showing us is it's tracking where everyone had open positions on Binance, BTC, USDT, USDT perp, you know, the most popular, I'm gonna get rid of this guy, the most popular futures. What we can see, guys, is where do you see a pocket, a place where really no one has positions open, the 22K to the 22.7 level. You can see it in a histogram here that looks at buys and sells combined with open interest, you know, rising and falling. What we can basically see is that around here, not too many people opened positions, okay, right? So there's not a lot of open positions in the 22K area and a little bit above. Now let's go into the main chart here. So again, that area that I'm talking about is right here. Guys, this area is primed for being hunted, meaning that price will very, very likely go up here and it will liquidate a lot of people and it will hurt a lot of people because there are a lot of people who are short. Why do I say there are a lot of people who are short? Well, look at this. Super simply, what do we see here? That the top traders' average leveraged used, shorts are very, very high right now. There is a lot of leveraged shorts, as you can see right here. And if we look in, you know, since August 6th, we are actually at our highest point of average leverage. Okay, now you might say, well, what happened last time that, you know, shorts were this over leveraged? Well, the last time that it was this high was right here. Now what happened right here is look, price squeezed, you know, the heck out of them, went up 4%. So there were a lot of shorts who were taking on a lot of leverage, i.e. this level was about 14x, which is the average leverage taken by an OKX futures trader. And then price, you know, killed them all. What is average leverage at now? It's gotten even higher. It's at about, you know, 14x, especially like, you know, right around here. So I'm expecting that price will very likely go up and it will probably, you know, smash this entire area and it will BART right back up. I don't really want this to be like a complete price prediction video. What I want to show more about this video is not just identifying a bullish or bearish bias, meaning that you're predicting where price will go, but where do we think price will go after you, you know, think it's going to go up or down. So just to recap the reasons why this area is, it's very likely for price to gravitate toward in the 22,000s very, very, very soon, is a lot of reasons. One, as we had talked before, when you do not see a lot of open positions in a certain price area, it's easier for price to go into that area. And there's a lot of good reasons why this happens. When a lot of people have open positions in a price area, what can happen is a lot of these people do one of two things. Anyone who's long and bought in the 23s and who wants to close their position at break even, what a lot of people will do is put sell orders at where they had bought, which is going to put selling pressure at that price level. If almost no one had open positions in the 22 to 22.8K range, well, what ends up happening is there probably won't be many limit sell orders, i.e. there aren't that many interested sellers. And if there aren't that many interested sellers in the 22K range, couple that with the fact that there's a lot of liquidation potential if price gets up to the 22K level, as I can see if I just zoom in right here. There's a lot of liquidation potential if price gets to that level right there. A lot of people up to, people who had shorted, you know, up to 25X leverage are gonna get obliterated here. And people with 20X leverage are gonna get obliterated, you know, probably a little bit higher if they just keep their short position open. So these are the reasons why targeting this area, I think, is, you know, probably not a terrible idea. So look, price could go lower, of course, but what I'm expecting to happen is likely, you know, potentially a BART-like move, we go up, and then we get a bunch of slippage as well. And this is the slippage indicator that basically shows us how many stop losses are being hit. Because the higher this amount is, that basically means that there are more market orders being hit than limit orders taking those market orders. And if there are many market orders occurring, then that can be a sign of a lot of stop losses happening and liquidations, of course. So I'm thinking that this price range right here, you know, the 22Ks is going to be primed for just like a quick BART, like a, I'm trying to make like weird 12-year-old spaceship sounds, alien sounds, like right up there. So basically that, I think, is really one of the best ways that you can go forth, not just saying, hey, I think price will rise or I think price will fall in the medium term, like I've done successfully in the past, but hopefully in this video you can now see what price area is price likely to reach. Reach being either it will reverse, it will get there, and then it will reverse, or if we're currently in an uptrend, where do we know that price is more likely to gravitate toward before reversing? And that area is the 22,000s. Again, the reason being that there isn't a lot of interested sellers there looking at people who have open positions. Two, there's a lot of liquidation potential. A lot of people who had shorted, you know, this current range and this current down move, they're going to get liquidated if/when price gets up to that 22K range. Now, if price goes lower, then of course this could change because, you know, we need to look at how indicators change if price goes lower. But for right now, I think that a lot of shorts could be obliterated very, very soon. And this is exactly how you can identify that. Looking at volume profile, looking at where open interest increased at different price levels, and then finally looking at where will people be liquidated. That's gonna do it for this video, and I'm gonna link High Block right here if you want it. You can also try to find these indicators on your own. Totally cool. So that's gonna do it. This is how you identify a short squeeze / long squeeze and how you identify exactly where you think price will reach. And best of luck.